The Attorney General has suspended the registration of the Atheists in Kenyan society. In fact, an update just came out this weekend, which says, bring up the graphics so I can bring everybody up to speed what this says. It says, following the receipt of representations made to the state law office by various religious and other organizations regarding the registration of the Atheist Society of Kenya, the Attorney General has directed the Registrar of Societies to suspend with immediate effect the said registration under Section 12(1)(b) of the Societies Act until the propriety, legality and constitutionality of the registration is determined by the Supreme Court. The Atheists are not having any of that. They went ahead to celebrate their registration yesterday. And let's discuss their attempt to get officially recognized. I've got a power panel here with me. Abdulrahman Wandati is back with us for the Muslim Consultative
Council.
Yes, Muslim Consultative
Council.
I've got also back with us Charles Kenjama, who's the Vice Chair of the Kenya Christian Professionals Forum and an advocate. Also with us is Harrison Mumia, who's the President and Founder of the Atheist in Kenya. And last but not least, Stephen Disho, former MP and Vice Chair of the Kenya
National Congress.
Kenya National Congress of Pentecostal Churches. Thank you, gentlemen, all for being here. First, your reaction, Harrison, to the AG suspending your registration.
No, we have not received any formal communication from the Office of Attorney General. So as far as we are concerned, we are still registered as a society. Until we receive that communication, then we should be able to take steps. The other thing is that you cannot suspend a society and the Societies Act by just giving a declaration. There's a procedure under Article 12 of the Societies Act, which basically says that the registrar has to actually give a reason why he is deregistering the Atheists in Kenya Society, one or why he is suspending the Atheists in Kenya Society. So it has to be a good reason, a reasonable one. It has also to be grounded in the Societies Act, which has grounds for deregistration or suspension. And to the best of our knowledge, we have been very, very law-abiding in as far as carrying out the activities of AIK is
okay.
Concerned.
One of the reasons has got to be because Mr. Ndisho's organization has asked the AG to resign for even registering the Atheists in Kenya to start with. Why is that?
Well, first of all, because by the first action of the Attorney General purporting to register it was offensive to the Constitution.
How so?
Beg your pardon?
How so? How is it offensive to the Constitution?
If you read the first line of our Constitution, the preamble says, we, the people of Kenya, acknowledging the supremacy of the Almighty God of our creation. Just that one, the Attorney General ought to have read that before he issues a registration certificate to an organization that says there is no that God which we that our Constitution acknowledges.
The loudest
and
complaint.
Therefore,
yes.
And therefore, I agree with him. The Attorney General ought not to have suspended that certificate. He ought to have cancelled it and deregister the organization.
The loudest complaints have come from the Christians and the Muslims.
My approach would be the following. Number one, first he has to tell us that God which he denies that he exists. So that then when I'm talking to him, I know that we are speaking the same language. Because as a Muslim in Islam, I'm taught that when I disagree with somebody, I must establish some commonality. Either we are equal in knowledge, or like in Kenya, we are equal as citizens, or there's something that brings us together. I think I share ancestry with him as well. So as a Luhia, he could be my uncle or my cousin. Our people have no concept of there not being God. They have a concept of idolatry. As Luhias, even the one who never believed in Christianity could believe in idolatry, but at least they know there is a God.
Right.
As people who have gone to school, there has to be a source of knowledge. What is his source? Me as a Muslim, I know that knowledge comes from either it's revealed or it's acquired through research. And the revealed will always be higher than the acquired knowledge. So I have a book, the Quran, which I follow. Let him tell us the book that he follows.
Do you follow any book?
There is no God.
Larry,
then
you
can
debate. Larry, let me tell you something. You know, it is very strange that we have a Muslim here and a Christian here. They believe in different books. They believe in different gods. They believe in different so-called divine, like he believes in Jesus, he believes in Mohammed. These guys are diverse in their beliefs. It is them to tell us why they believe in different gods, not the atheist to say that, to explain why he doesn't believe in God. And if you invited a Hindu here, the Hindu will also come in with his book and his beliefs. The problem is this many religions. The problem is not the atheist who denies them all. It is the religions who are so split, so divided.
The substance of this conversation.
They don't even agree amongst themselves.
Hang on. The substance of this conversation is not even about the religions or the beliefs themselves, about the legality of the registration. So that is why we've got Charles Kanjama here, who is an advocate. What do you make of the AG's decision to suspend the registration of this society?
I think the AG was responding to public pressure. And there's a sense in which the comments by the Pentecostal group is very solid about the preamble of the Constitution. And yet, on the other hand, the AG seems to have acted without following due process. I agree with Harrison to the extent that the Societies Act requires one to be given a hearing before suspending. So I would like to delve into this matter in greater detail. I think there are two key questions. One is a substantive question, and the second is a procedural question. In terms of procedure, once the society was registered, whether it was rightly or wrongly, to deregister or suspend it, you must follow a procedure. That procedure involves giving a notice to show cause, involves Article 47 of the Constitution and fair administrative action.
Right.
So I think there may be a point about the need for procedure. But on the substantive question, that requires a review of several articles of the Constitution, not just the preamble. Article 32 on freedom of religion and conscience, Article 33 on freedom of expression, Article 36 on freedom of association. And I think it's a question that the courts have grappled with. There's no, I would say, totally clear-cut answer, but I think there's one significant difference between Kenya's constitution and those of some other countries that may have interpreted freedom of association differently,
right,
which is that our preamble actually entrenches our constitution and we the people in our social contract in a belief or acknowledgement of the supremacy of Almighty God of all creation. So these are the issues that will have to be considered substantively, even as we deal with the procedural questions about whether it was right, it was in the public interest to register this society.
Gentlemen, let's leave it there just for the moment because I have to take a very quick break. We'll come back and continue the conversation on whether or not the atheists need to be registered. And we're looking at your comments on the hashtag Without God. We're taking a break. We'll be right back.
Islamic article of faith starts with there is no God to be worshipped
except
other than. Exactly. So maybe extent we're together.
If you want to go, your camera people have disappeared. Okay. Fair enough.
And we're back with my panel discussing whether or not the Atheist Society should have been suspended its registration by the Attorney General. And this gentleman is still here. An important distinction, Harrison, somebody asks, are you an atheist or an anti-theist? Because you seem to exhibit characteristics of the latter.
I'm both. I'm an atheist. I'm also an anti-theist, which basically means that there are practices within religious circles that I find very, very bad.
And yet you keep a religious name. You keep Harrison.
Well, Harrison is a name I was given by my mom. I've not bothered to change it. I think it's just because I do not want to go through. I would have to change a lot of other documents. But it does not define what I believe in. It does not define who I am.
Mr. Ndisho, the contradiction here is as Christians, you're supposed to love everybody. And yet you are very vehemently opposed even to the idea of this organization existing.
Well, we are opposed to the organization, not hating my fellow human being here. I love him.
You don't?
You can't judge me.
aren't you judging him and people like him?
No, what I'm judging is the action of telling us that there is no God. And this is absurd. Any human being knows that there is God, except very few. But let me say this, Harari. Harrison and his ilk are saying there's no God. He is not the first one. He shall not be the last one. They shall always come in generations. There was a man who was called the Pharaoh of Egypt. When Moses went there and told him, God has told him, let my people go to sacrifice for me in the wilderness, the Pharaoh said, who is the Lord that I should allow the Israelites to go to offer sacrifice to him? There was a man who was called Nebuchadnezzar, who said, it is only me to be worshipped. There was another man who was called Goliath. And David is telling Goliath, you are insulting the armies of the living God. And Goliath spit and say, who is Jehovah? Now, when my friend will meet those guys, wherever they shall meet, they shall tell him a story of the people who had a contemptuous attitude towards God.
Mr. Wandati, isn't this intolerance from the mainstream religions a little troubling? That you want people to believe in what you believe in or nothing at all?
No, that's not what I've said. In fact, Islam has a history where Islam has, can I say that as far as I'm concerned as a Muslim, we have the experience of people claiming to be God, of people worshipping idols.
Or people not worshipping anything at all?
I don't have that experience. Now, I think Harrison has helped me when he says he's anti-theist. I was grappling with that question when I was coming. Probably the God that Harrison says he does not believe in is a Western God, Zeus. So if you have a problem with Zeus, I agree with you, I have no problem. As a Muslim, I have no problem with you if your problem is with Zeus. But if your problem is with Allah, okay, then I will tell you who Allah is. Then you will tell me, by the way, we are talking about practice. Our practice is defined by belief. First, you have to believe, and having belief, you have to behave in a certain manner.
All right.
So if your problem is with Allah, then I have a discussion with you. If it is not with Allah, I have no problem.
Kanjama, does the state even have business deciding who can believe in what, or determining that if you don't believe in something, then you don't have a right to be registered?
I think the state has to balance between competing rights. This is the essence of Article 24 of the Constitution on fundamental rights being limited, including the right of freedom of association. If I want to register an association that will be harmful to the public good or the common good, an association, for example, that promotes discrimination against one of the grounds prohibited in Article 27, then the state cannot register. So to the extent that my brother Harrison says that he's anti-theist, then he would clearly be seeking registration of an organization that can attack religion, attack religious practices. It would be like seeking an organization registered to attack people of a certain ethnicity, a certain gender. So that kind of organization cannot be registered. But individually, no one can be compelled to believe or not to believe in a particular religion.
Harrison, you seem to enjoy antagonizing the main religions.
I think let us get one thing clear. Religions are not immune from we're not stopped from thinking anything about religion. It's not a very, it's not immune from opinion. It's not immune from challenge. You can examine the Bible, for example, and arrive at a conclusion about a story. For example, the story of Noah. If Noah drowned, God drowned the people in the story of Noah, and you find that that act was not an act of love for the people who were drowned, and you say that on Facebook, that in the story of Noah, I think God was a bit harsh. God was not fair to the people who died.
What you do is you seem to take pleasure in knocking down the beliefs of others.
No, I think what we are doing,
as sport.
No. I think what if the religious people are very confident about their God, really they should not worry about what Mumia says about their God and what Mumia says about the Bible, the Quran. You see, what's happening is religious people have lived for a long time in this very, very untouchable kind of situation. So we were not allowed to comment about the Bible. When you go into a church, you are supposed to just listen to the pastor and then go home. You are not allowed to even question the Bible.
All right.
Now, we're in the 21st century, we have knowledge. Things like even the very existence of Jesus are being challenged in the secular academic world. Now, are you telling me that you want to come with the Bible, romp it over me, and tell me you must believe what the Bible says? Look, I'm an educated person.
Have you always been an atheist?
No. I got saved from being religious. I mean,
Why you were a Christian at some point?
I was a Christian at some point.
When did you become an atheist?
I became an atheist after, it was progressive though, but ultimately after campus I realized that the stories of the Bible, the Quran and many other mythical stories are not really true, they're not facts.
Mythical stories, you say?
Yeah, yeah.
Mr. Ndishi, would you agree?
I want to come back to the same question you asked. why he likes to be, you know, controversial and rubbing the other guy's wrong way. On the 14th of January this year, they made an application, and this is also what my other friend said. Mm-hmm. They made an application to the Attorney General's office, and this is the reply from the Principal State Council of Societies. He wrote, the Secretary, Atheist of in Kenya Society, PO Box, something in Mombasa, Societies Act, Cap 108. I, Maria Nyariki, Principal State Council of Societies, hereby give you notice that in accordance with Section 11 of the Societies Act, I have this day refused to register you as a society under the said act on the following ground. The registrar has reasonable cause to believe that in the interest of peace, welfare, or good order in Kenya, would be likely to suffer prejudice by reason of your registration as a society.
All right.
Dated Nairobi this 14th day of January 2016. Just a minute. This was a reply of their registration.
Their request for registration.
Yes. We want to know between this letter, because the lady who signed now the certificate, the certificate of registration, Mukulu N. Kariuki Mrs.
Right.
The deputy registrar of societies, seems as if she was under some direction from a higher officer, either the Attorney General or the Registrar General.
What's your reading of this, Kanjama? The initial letter denying the registration, was that legally sound?
It was under Section 11 of the Societies Act. The grounds upon which you can deny registration, that's what she was reading. That was one of the grounds.
Right.
It is legally sound. Of course, the question is whether the Constitution and Article 36, the right of association, is consistent with Section 11 of the Societies Act. I do believe it is, because Section 11 of the Societies Act merely expresses what you would find in Article 24 of the Constitution, the limitation to the right of association. And I think there's a legitimate question, what happened from the moment the decision was communicated to reject registration until it was allowed? Was there an appeal? Did the matter go to court?
Okay.
That is the question.
There was actually an appeal.
Real quick, because I need to wrap up. Yes.
Yes, we appealed the decision to be disallowed to get registration, and our appeal actually went through. Basically, the Attorney General, because we delivered the appeal to the Attorney General, he looked at it. And it is after looking at it that he gave us the certificate of registration.
How come the Attorney General has since changed his mind?
This is the question we are also asking. I mean, you cannot register us in February, and in April you are deregistering us. without any grounds.
Is this just you seeking to make your name? Because do you have actual members of this society?
They're actually WhatsApping me right now. You know,
do you have actual members? Because you had a party, you had a party, and you posted a picture publicly.
We had a party.
You posted a picture publicly.
Yes.
It has seven other people apart from you. That doesn't seem to be a lot of people.
No. Look,
this is available publicly on your social media pages.
Let me just say that we have an executive. We have a leadership, which according to the act, by the way, we need to have a president, a vice president, a secretary, a treasurer, and so on and so forth. Now, we have a register we are developing. After the registration, we have to comply with the society.
So how many members exist of the society at the moment?
We are about 100 members right
now. You're about 100
members. Registered members, yes.
So that's not a lot of people. You shouldn't be too concerned, Mr. Ondati.
No, I'm not concerned. But he can register whoever he wants. But all he has to help me understand is tell me this God he's denying. Can he define him? Let him tell me. This
okay.
is the God I believe.
As we wrap up.
As he's thinking, I will tell him the God I believe in.
Okay.
I'll quote two places of the Quran. The first one says, Qul huwallahu ahad. I'm ordered to say he's only one God. Allahu samad. It is God who can be relied upon for anything. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He's never begotten nor he was neither begotten nor has he begotten. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. And neither is there any one single thing that looks like him. That's one God.
I'm
quoting only one part.
Okay.
So I'm able to describe, define this God that I believe in.
So you think he's misguided?
Let him tell us the God he does not believe in.
That's a difficult
question. I need to really, you all may have to make really short comments as we finish.
Well, one, let me put the position of Christianity. We have got no problem with anybody who doesn't belong in God.
Brethren,
yeah. We have no problem.
Okay.
Actually, our problem is the registration of a society that says there's no God.
Isn't that a contradiction? You just said the first part you have no problem with it existing, but you don't want it registered.
No. Our problem, we came here. These guys came in 2013. It's when they started making this issue about there's no God.
Okay. All right.
And we said, well, anybody can say there's no God.
Okay.
But until they got the registration, we said now the Attorney General, you have offended the same constitution you have sworn to protect.
All right, let's leave it at Harrison, 10 seconds.
Let me say this. When I was a Christian, before I became an atheist, they used to be pastors who used to teach love, tolerance. These are the things we were told. God is good. He will also, he wants you to come to his fold. Look at what the religious people are doing to atheists.
All right.
They're not living up to the standards and expectations of their gods,
who
they claim to be love.
All right, Kanjama, final word is on you.
Let me say that we must avoid intolerance. We must also avoid the intolerance of tolerance or the tolerance of intolerance. And I think what you're finding here with Harrison, at least his organization and the stance of anti-theism, is pushing intolerance against religion.
Okay.
That is a problem.
All right, and we'll leave it there. I'm really out of time, Mr. Ondati.
You don't believe in God. Do you believe in Satan?
Am I allowed to answer that?
Do you believe in Satan?
Do you believe in Satan?
I do not believe in Satan.
Okay.
Believe in
Satan. So you're not a Satanist?
I'm not a Satanist. I'm okay. Very here to clarify that.
All right.
Atheism is not Satanism. Mm-hmm. It is the religious people who believe in Satan. It is not the atheists.
All right, Mr. Ondati, Mr. Kanjama, Mr. Mumia, and Mr. Ndisho. Thank you all so much for being here. What an interesting conversation.